we love putting different finishes on our furniture pieces. We're always trying to come up with new ideas, and I think for us, it's one of our favorite parts of the build.
The finish is really what makes the piece of furniture go to the next level. It gives it that unique character.
And recently we built our friend, the Alvarez's, a beautiful dining table. If y'all missed it, make sure you click the link below. You'll be able to see it. And we've had just so many requests asking about that finish we did on that table.
And it actually is very, very simple, just following a few steps with a couple of products.
So we thought it'd be really fun to kind of break that down for you and show it to you today. So let's get started.
You're gonna want a little cup of water. You're gonna want a little bit of paint.
And we can link to the paint below that we use.
You're gonna want a stain, any color will do. We'll link to our stain below also. And then you're going to want to use a chalk paint brush, very important.
Linking to that as well. And some rough sandpaper.
So step one.
Step one, gloves.
Yeah, step one is gloves. Gotta protect the manicure, guys. And girls. Step one is to stain the raw wood.
And what? Stain? Why?
We're staining because at the very end of this, once we put the paint on, we want to see that stain after we distress it pop through that paint. So you really need to think about what color you want to show through the paint when you're picking out your stain color.
Do, 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 do.
All right, we're using a gel stain. It's chestnut color. We will put a link in the description box below. And staining is super easy. And what is the difference between a gel stain and a regular stain? It's like very jelly and it doesn't drip. Like if you've used stain a lot, it's very, very watery.
We actually had to finish this table inside of the Alvarez house. They really appreciated us not using a dripping stain.
On their brand new hardwood floors. So I think chalk paint is a really fun technique to use on a piece that has a lot of edges because you can really draw out that decorative trim with the distressing technique.
But now we need to wait for this to dry.
Oh, it dried.
Look at that.
Stain's dry.
So we get to move on to step two, which is the fun part. Step two is gonna be adding this chalk paint. Now we found it's our current favorite chalk paint. We'll be sharing a link in the description box below. It's really inexpensive and it goes on super smooth, but that's with a few tips. So first of all, chalk paint brush, linking to it below. This thing's awesome and it just helps the paint go on really thick and also really smooth. But then the second tip, what we're gonna do, we're dipping it in our paint first, but then we're just gonna lightly dab it in the water. And all that's gonna do is help us to get that paint to go on smoothly, which is exactly what it's doing. And 2 minutes later.
Here, put it right here.
This, thank you, this guy's done. Now, at this point, you can go take a nap, go take care of your kids.
You gotta let it dry. Get a cup of coffee. Now it's dry.
Now the fun part.
This is the fun part, distressing. You wanna use, we like to use like an 80 grit, you can use 60 grit. We like to start on the edges, and the more you distress, the more stain's gonna show through.
One of the goals here is to actually have your piece look like a vintage antique piece of furniture. It's getting bumped around and hit around, and you wanna think about those edges or what's actually gonna cause the rub off that we're trying to like emulate here.
You really can't mess it up. It's whatever you want it to look like.
Oh, now I want to go chalk paint my table.
I know. All right, so I like it like that.
Right there. Now, at this point, we have finished. However, we always recommend polyurethane over this. We have a triple thick polyurethane that we've used before. That one's really great too.
That one's great over like white so it doesn't yellow.
And the key is you want a satin finish or a matte finish because that's the finish that you're getting with the chalk paint. So you want to make sure that your finish you put on top of it matches that also.
All right, and we have chalked up another video.
And that has been Chalk Paint, Shady Style. So,
I will chalk your life away.
There you go.